Hey everyone, I just want to bring you my final review of the Arc'teryx Aireus FL GTX shoe. I've had this shoe now for 7 months. I've worn it consistently since the start of November all the way up to early May. And for context, I've worn this about 80% on the trails and about 20% on sidewalks and pavement. The main thing I want to touch on today after 7 months of consistent use is just the durability of the shoe. So the first thing about the durability that I wanted to touch on was the outsole. And to be honest, since I wore this mostly on trails, there wasn't that much friction in its softer type terrain. But the 20% that I did take the dog out in the city and on the sidewalks, I did notice that some of the 4 foot lugs in the central area here were getting slightly more worn out than the other ones, but obviously that's a pressure point, and depending on how you move, if you twist off the 4 foot, they are going to wear out a little bit quicker. Now with that being said, because these lugs are pretty flat, this is made for a trail shoe, but you can easily get away with this walking in the city or on the sidewalks. It's a very versatile type shoe. Now one thing that I did notice is it's very subtle, but if you look between the outsole and the midsole, it is slightly coming unglued a little bit, but even when I pull at it, if I don't pull too hard, it's very subtle, but I'm sure over time that's gonna be a spot that kind of opens up as more debris and liquid gets in there. The midsole has consistently been nice and comfortable for me. Stiffness that was in the shoe has stayed relatively the same. It gives good forefoot and midfoot protection when you're out walking on the trails. Now, when we move up to the upper, one thing I like about this shoe, which I don't know if I talked about in the first video, is this more solid type plate that wraps literally around the entire shoe onto the inside of the foot and all the way to the outside. It's a lot more firm than the rest of the upper. It gives a lot more stability. And I thought that part would actually come unglued between itself and the upper, but it hasn't. It's been relatively durable. And I really like how well it's held up. Now, if you follow that all the way up to the top here in the toe, there is this toe cap that is extremely durable. It's this thick rubberized material, and it is loaded with scratches and scrapes, but there are no dings, there's no rips in it, there's nothing. And I mean, I've kicked my toe off everything, and it's held up remarkably well. One thing that's oddly different about this toe cap is that it wraps over the top of your toes ever so slightly. I like that. I think it gives a little bit more added protection, especially as you pick up your foot in case you clip something on the tip of your toe. However, the only thing I would change with this is if you look at it, you can see how it kind of sticks up from the rest of the toe box. And one thing I noticed, this is such a minor detail and it's happened to me. I'm not sure if this has happened to anybody else who's owned these shoes, but every time I stepped out of my truck, I've noticed that this little lip here would get caught on the part of my door on my truck, and it didn't drive me nuts, but you just had to be careful because a few times I stumbled out of the truck, and I'm sure other people have noticed getting it caught on other things, but I'd love to see if this tapered down slightly into the toe box rather than having this big kind of chunky lip there that's getting caught on some things. But when we speak about durability, it held up so well. As we move up to the upper, this is the Gore-Tex portion of the shoe that is waterproof. I first have to say the waterproofability of the shoe has been fabulous. We have the Gore-Tex obviously, but we also have the sewn-in tongue, which I talked about in the first video as well. So I've not once have I noticed any wetness or dampness into my socks other than just sweat. But I actually found it fairly breathable for a Gore-Tex shoe. Usually I don't say that, but it has also been over colder months. So, I mean, if I tested it through the summer, I would definitely let you know if it breathed as well as I thought it did during the winter. Last but not least is the lacing system. So this is something that always is a pet peeve of mine, and it can drive me up a wall as if the lacing system wears out and if I really like the shoe to begin with, but the first thing that goes is the lacing system. So I hate when that happens. I was a little bit skeptical of the way the lacing system was set up with these, they're just fabric type loops. They look literally like they put little mini shoelaces around the actual shoelace. But the way it laces up is very smooth and it hasn't worn out at all. None of the stitching has come loose whatsoever. And then the last thing is up at the top here, they have these metal eyelets, and you can see it kind of sticks out. I'm not sure if you can pick that up, but I thought there'd be some abrasion pulling on these laces over and over again, but the laces are in mint condition. They don't have any wear or tear on them yet. So I was pleasantly surprised with that as well. So overall, what would I suggest this shoe for? This shoe is like an amazing, just an amazing utility shoe. You could wear this, you know, all four seasons if you really want, but because if you're in a climate like mine, where you can get dumpings of snow at a time, this is gonna be too low, and obviously snow's gonna get into your ankles. But it is waterproof, so that's good. The tread could be a little bit better for the winter. So if you're in a moderate type climate where you don't get a lot of snow, you might get sleet in the winter, or you get just minor snowfalls or a couple centimeters, then this would be a fabulous shoe to use around town during those winter months and then take it on the trails during the other three seasons. There is a mid version of this shoe, so a higher cut version of this shoe. I would love to test that out. I think that would be very functional as well for what we have in the area I'm in. But overall, love the Arius FL. It's been great, and I'm gonna continue to use this one in the trails and probably into next fall as well.